Hi YouTube. Today I'll be making a video on how to use this wool to make African threading. That is African threading with this. So guys, stay tuned and watch my video. Please don't forget to subscribe, thumbs up, share, and like this video. I love you all. Thank you guys. So, I have to prepare this. Today I just finished washing my hair, and this video will be too long. So this is it. Just finished preparing it. I have to cut it. It's very long, and this is very colorful. I like the color, you can see the color. So guys, let us begin. So to start, I wash the hair. This is my cream. I have to shear it, divide the hair. And this African threading, I will be making a bigger one. Before, I used to make about 15 hair. And I don't care if it is neat or not. Now for my edges have been growing. You can see the hairs now, they are growing. Thank God. So and after washing my hair, this is what I got, the shading. I don't know if it is breaking or this is only shedding, guys. They are long. I think it is shedding because I did the African threading. I left it, but I used to wash it every week. I left it on for 3 weeks. So today I just washed it and I loosed it and I washed my hair with shampoo and leaving in deep condition, normal deep condition. That's what I did. So guys, this is it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 2 here, 3 here, and 1 here. So whenever you want to divide your hair, always leave one here, so that you will not have what is it called? Breakage at the middle of your hair. Always leave one at the middle whenever you divide your hair. Don't just divide it and leave here spaced. So what I'm going to do, I'll start with this and I have to spread because this is my hair. I've not moisturized it.
Essential oil, so that I can able to add more choice to cover those